Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Genetic Basis of Inheritance. In that, we are studying topic Human Skin Color. Now, every individual has different skin color which are decided by the alleles. Today, let's study what are the combination that takes place. Human skin color. Whenever I talk about human skin color, if I say that human skin color is a polygenic trait. Polygenic traits are those traits whose expression is brought about a pair of genes, or you can say by a set of genes. Whenever human skin color has been decided, if an individual has capital A, capital A, capital B, capital B, and capital C, capital C, then the set of genes are denoted as dark skin color or dark set of genes, whereas all the small alphabets denote light set of genes. If an individual seems to have capital A, small a, capital B, small b, and small c, small c, then that individual is heterozygous for all the gene. And when the individual is heterozygous for all the gene, the color mulatto is the color that's seen. Now, depending upon the homozygosity or the heterozygosity present in skin color, every individual's skin colors vary. Variations or differences in characteristics in seen through generations. Now, heredity says that certain traits are just passed from generation to generation, but in skin color, yes, skin color is passed from generation to generation, from parents to their offsprings and then to their offsprings. But there is always certain changes. There's always certain permutation and combination which is seen thoroughly. Human skin color. Now let's see, human skin color is basically controlled by polygenic trait. And when I talk about polygenic trait, these are nothing but group of genes, or you can say a set of genes which decide a particular characteristics. For example, skin color is a particular trait or characteristics present in human beings. Now this character is decided by a set of genes or alleles that you get from your parents, both your mother and father. Now half set you get it from your father and half set you get it from your mother. That is why human skin color is termed as a polygenic trait. Each gene contributes to a unit of darkness due to its incomplete dominance. The skin shade varies from very dark, that's capital A, capital A, capital B, capital B, capital C, capital C individual, to very light, which is denoted by small alphabets. A person with these sets of alleles is always heterozygous for all the three genes and will have an intermediate color termed as mulatto. Whereas the number of possible combinations that can be there in gametes is total 8. We have seen that. So in totality, there are 64 phenotypic combinations, that is 64 color variations in skin color can be observed in human beings when two people of almost similar genetic makeup marry each other. So one can be said that if two people who are on the fairer side but have slight genetic makeup change, if they end up marrying each other, there could be 64 different combinations of skin color that could be obtained in a long run. One of the important features of skin color determination is also the atmospheric conditions. Apart from that, territorial boundaries may also affect your skin color, not the same as the genetic makeup, but to a certain extent. For example, people towards the poles tend to be on the fairer side due to less amount of sun and more colder temperature, whereas people in southern states of India tend to be on the more darker zone due to the climatic condition and the food. People in Africa will have a certain skin color due to the genetic inheritance or the genes or gametes or set of genes which they tend to have. In this human skin color trait, what we can notice in simple trick is that a particular skin trait is decided by permutation and combination of all the alleles which you have, basically all the polygenic traits which you tend to have. Students, in this part of the chapter, what we did study was about the human skin color and how the different combinations and permutations happen in that. I hope you all are clear with this concept of human skin color and its polygenic effect and traits. Thank you.